Lawyers say he's guilty of murdering a visiting scholar at the U of I. Now he's heard on tape saying he's killed before.
Yeah, that chilling testimony, just one of several developments in this federal death penalty case now playing out in Peoria. WGN's Tom Negeman is live there with the latest. Tom?
That's right. You know, some of this jurors have heard before. All of it is very graphic, extremely violent. The defendant heard on tape describing how his victim fought for her life, describing himself as a serial killer, rivaling Jeffrey Dahmer and John Wayne Gacy. News footage and evidence photos show them together at a June 2007 vigil for missing University of Illinois scholar Yingying Zhang. Tara Bullis says her then boyfriend, Brendt Christensen, was adamant they had to attend, and that when he saw the crowd, he matter-of-factly said, "They're here for me," later typing three lines into her cell phone. "It was me. She was number 13. She is gone forever."
Do you have any questions for me before why am I under suspicion? Is it just my car?
He's already been interviewed by the FBI, worries they may be closing in, but never suspects his girlfriend is wearing a wire. On tape, he tells her, "I am apparently very good at this." She says he's upbeat despite the somber vigil, wants to talk about the murder, and at one point she says, "He took my left hand and with his fingertips, he traced something on my hand. It took me a second, but he was writing the number 13. It's a number he keeps coming back to." Of his victim's heartbroken family who've come from China to find her, he says they'll go home empty-handed, repeating, "I told you, I'm on victim number 13, counting Yingying." He describes the killing in intense detail, how long it took, how hard she fought, how fearful he is of police. "Yingying is the only person that has produced evidence that leads back to me, number 13. I've been at this since I was 19.
Now, the FBI has looked into that claim of 12 additional victims, found nothing to support it. His defense team is very focused on that, very myopic, trying to convince the same jury that will decide the death penalty phase of this, that Yingying Zhang was Brendt Christensen's only victim. Live at the federal courthouse in Peoria, Tom Negevin, WGN News.